White-collar migrant worker, making your way in the gig economy. Written by Gerald Everett Jones. Narrated by Gina Rogers. Your next job is a project. Here's the bad news. Your old job doesn't exist. You no longer have a job description. Duh, that's because you don't have a job. Instead, in your new incarnation as a white-collar migrant worker, you have an assignment. And associated with that assignment may be a task. But don't take those descriptions too seriously. You might find them misleading, needlessly confining, or totally useless. The good news is you can write your new job description. The bad news is you should write it in pencil. You don't have a position. You don't fit anywhere in the organization chart. That's because, in a legalistic sort of way, you don't work at any particular place. And under certain circumstances, for example, if things go south, it will be convenient for them to deny they ever even saw you. You're not employed by the people who gave you the assignment, but by a vendor that might call itself a staffing agency or a consulting firm. There's a difference, which is unimportant for now. Those people might not know you either. They are filling a gap, usually on short notice. Something in your resume fit the client's spec. A screener in the staffing place couldn't find anything wrong with you. You might have even passed some kind of test. Don't let it go to your head. Or you're a known quantity to the consulting firm, but the client has never met you, and they gave you the assignment anyway. You are a temp, which is a diminutive term often applied to casual clerical labor, but you could just as well be an expert database architect or literally a rocket scientist. You're still a temp. Your assignment has a specific start date and a projected end date. And end it will. Count on that. Sooner or later than anyone anticipates. About the only element of this assignment that is set in stone is your labor rate. It might be hourly pay, a project fee, or a piece rate, but all the same, it's a done deal. There will be no promotions, no bonuses. And benefits? We'll defer that discussion, but suffice it to say, as far as perks are concerned, the only extra rewards you will get will be from your best friend in the mirror. What do they mean, overqualified? Here's a piece of good news. You probably think you're overqualified, but that word has no meaning within the context of a temporary assignment. In the traditional world of permanent employees, overqualified describes an employee who is likely to be unhappy because he's not sufficiently challenged, who may resent taking direction from less experienced team members, and who will probably start lobbying for a raise from day one. But since in your new circumstances, the labor rate is fixed, and since you've already agreed to the terms of the assignment, neither you nor the client has anything to complain about. If you're overqualified, you're simply bringing more expertise to the assignment than they think they need. But beware, use of the term overqualified with a contract employee can be code for, don't you realize you're too old? Overqualified means you might be competition, or you might dress old school and not fit in with the after-work drinking crowd. No young middle manager wants to hire, much less listen to advice from her mother. From your standpoint, understand that being overqualified is your secret, mandatory qualification to succeed as a consultant. That's because you probably have enough experience and judgment to correctly analyze the client's business situation. And with your objectivity as an outsider, you may be uniquely qualified to find out exactly what's broken and needs fixing, not just the perceived problem your assignment was intended to solve. Now here's the biggest mistake you are likely to make. You will be eager to prove you are just as good as a so-called permanent employee. You want to prove that you deserve to be retained as soon as your worth is recognized as a direct hire with a real position, an eager staff, a corner office, and a handsome package of benefits. This will not, indeed, should not happen. Yes, there are assignments billed as temp to perm, or contract to hire, meaning we get to sniff you for a few months before we commit to doing it for real. However, and this is one of the main themes of this book, attractive as that prospect might be, the perm jobs are fast disappearing. That person sitting in the corner office who seems so comfy might already be dead and just not know it yet. Your strategic.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.